Hi friends, this is Reason. You are welcome to this presentation. We are going to be modeling this car park, a complete modeling of this car park in this presentation. And we want you to stay tuned, like the lesson. If you are here to subscribe, subscribe, as I will be bringing you an advanced lesson of this kind on this channel, Self Reason. Always. So stay tuned and let's get started. I will navigate to the new tab right there, and then I will choose my project name, and I will change this provision to car. Car park, just like this. Alright, car park design. So I will be using this code, UK Euro codes, right away, the template, and then I will click on it. Okay. So that has created a new template for us. All right. So straight away, I will go to the modeling tab, click right there, and then navigate to the orthogonal axis generator. I'll click right there and select the scene area in these provisions. The span of the truss is 15 meters. So I will add up 15 meter, and it's going to be a single spacing, so I will have to place one right there. All right, then the offset of the polines, we'll be using polines space of as in the space of the trusses. All right, it's going to be 4800 millimeters. All right, just like this. Okay, and then it's going to be multiplied by say 6 provisions, just like that. Okay. So this is the settings, all right, for the car park. Click on the OK options to insert the grid lines, just like this, all right. Straight away, we navigate to the columns right away. So in this column provisions, we'll be using a column sections 250s by 250, just like this, okay. And then we place the columns right here. The height is just 3 meters, all right, a default height of the program. We'll check that out later. So I'll do a shade over the columns here. The grid line intersections, so as to be able to insert my columns just like this successfully. Then for the columns of this side, you know, there is a difference in height between the column in these provisions and the column in these other provisions. All right, the difference in height, this particular one, the height is 2.5 meter above this one. So you have to set that out in this columns property dialog. All right, so I will go straight away to the 3D provisions. The dealt tops directions, I will set it to 2500, right, for the columns in these provisions. So I will just have to do a sheet over these grid lines and stack sections to have that placed successfully. I'll close this, right? So after which I will be having another grid lines at the center of this set out, so I can be able to minimize the length of the ground beams, all right. For proper rigidity, I will select that one, right click, and then I will click on offset, and then I'll take it to the center placed right here. So I'll be having a column 2 right here, right? But we will set out that column, okay, or we can just set it out at once, okay? So we click on the columns, all right? So in these provisions, come over here. This time around, I'll be having minus 2000, and by the time I get to 3D, you will actually see what I meant. Okay, so minus 2000, I want the columns to be shortened by, this is a 3 meter height, so I just want it to be shortened by 2000. That is why I prefix the 2000 right there with minus. Okay, so I will insert this column right here. So after which I click on the close button, options to close the dialog, and navigate to the 3D to see what we've done so far. So this is how it's going to be, you can see, all right? So straight away we will be inserting the beams. Okay, select the beams. We will be having a beam of 250 by 450, just like this. Okay, and then I'll click on the first column point, the last one to insert the beam right there, just like that. And then this one, the same thing, all right, just like this. This is wrong instructions, all right, so you just have to undo that. Okay, you select this beam to reinsert again the property, pick the first point and second point to insert that successfully. Okay, so we continue the instructions right away. We have another beam here. Okay, This is based on the design. All right, it's actually based on the design. Okay, just like this. So after which we will navigate to the ground level. So I have to close this dialog. So and then you navigate to this story zero level, this level, and then we have to insert the ground the splint beam, right? The splint beam, not the ground beam, but splint beam, right? From this point to that point, we have a beam there right away. This provisions, this one, and have it right there. Okay, so I notice this beam is right on the ground. We want to take this beam because it's not a ground beam. It's not supposed to be on the foundations level. It's supposed to be at the splint level, right? This level, or the DPC level, right? So for us to take the beams there, we will navigate to the beams and get all the beams selected, right? You can see FB beam, so hold the shift key to select all, just like this. To take it, but the depth of the beam is what is 450 and the foundation depth is 1100, so we have to subtract 1100 from 450, and then we'll be having 650, right? We have a 650, so we just have to right click right there, click on the property. So in the property the summary table dialog, we will navigate to these provisions and then click on the edit input 650 right there. All right, 650, just like this. Click on okay. So once it appears and changes here, you click on okay right there. So you see the beams has been moved from the foundations levels to the DPC level right there. So we'll proceed to place the beam in this center column right there, just like this, and then we'll connect these provisions as well, just like that, as well as this. Okay, so this is a car park, and so we have to design it in a way that it will not cost a failure in no distance time. All right, so we will provide a beam right there, and as well this column to that column, just like this. All right, so after which we close this dialog, and then we'll be inserting slab. All right, go to modeling tab and then click on this slab right there. The slab thickness we will be using is slab thickness 250, right? 250 slab thickness. Mind you, we intend to design this as a raft, all right? So that's why we are considering the thickness 250 slab, right? Go to the loads, additional load of a 2 kilonewton per square meters. For the imposed load, we navigate to car park. See car park, this one, we'll be using this, right? So after which, for us to be able to get the slab, like if I place the slab there, it go to the foundations, right, on the foundations, all right? So I want to get it up. So to get it up, you have to subtract the 250 from the foundation depth, which is 1100, which you will now be having 850, all right? The 850, come to the general tab, and then where you have this relative level, you just input the 850, all right, just like this. And then if you click on the update, it takes it to the DPC level, okay, the split beam level. So you continue the instructions, all right, just like this. And then so when you're done, you have to close the dialog. Okay, so we have successfully inserted the columns as well as the beam. Now for the trusses, we navigate to the modeling tab, come to steel member. All right, before then, to enable this process, you have to move the grid lines from the foundation level to the story one level. All right, so we have to do that immediately. So we minimize this and then double click on story one to get the grid lines up to that levels. All right, to check these levels and the depth of the foundations, we have to edit these stories, and then you see we are considering 3 meters. All right, 3 meters height. Alright, then the foundation, you can see, is 1100 at default, and that is what we will be working with. Alright, click on the OK and then say yes options. So for the trust is now, come to the trust members tab right there, select the trust. You have to pick the first point and then you pick the second point, alright, of the trust. Then the trust dialog will come up. In the trust dialog, we are considering this trust, this one, alright. So what we need to do, we can select any of the patterns that we want in this provision, alright. So we're using this pattern, all right? So For this pattern, we will have to adjust the settings of this, alright, the apex height, alright, we will be using 1 meter, okay, and also the span is 15,000 millimeters, so we'll be having the spacing between the trusses instead of 2,500, we'll be having it up to, let me say, maybe 1,000 something, just like this, okay, this is good enough. So after which, see, this truss support is going to be bottom cut. Then the next thing we're going to set right here is the cantilever. We are setting the cantilever left to be 100, and then the right vertical offset, which we will have it to be 2,500, just like this. All right. So, and we have to check right there the orientations of the verticals is going to be global. Alright, so for the thrust profile, come to the member, these are the profiles of the trusses. Alright, you can change them, alright, but for the sake of this lesson, we'll be considering this. Okay, so just click on okay options to insert the truss just like this, and then you continue to insert the trusses just like that. Continue to insert it. Okay, all right, just like that. So we have successfully inserted the trusses. So we are going to be having our trusses at this point, okay, at this height. So we won't go back to the steel truss, steel members with truss again. So you pick the first point, this point, and then to the last point, this one. So we will be editing and adjusting this as well. Okay, so what we need to do, this provisions, where we have 0, we have 2,500 right there. So after which we will proceed. We may not necessarily have a cantilever. So for the cantilever, we have a 0 right there, and then click on the OK button to insert that. All right, so this is the truss we just inserted successfully, and the next thing is the pole lines. We are inserting pole lines, so you have to navigate to the steel members tab again, select the pole lines. Okay, pick the first thrust and then the last one. So the pole lines will automatically be inserted just like this. So for the adjustment, the spacings, the pole lines takes the spacing between the vertical part of the trusses. Okay, so if you don't want that spacing, you can change the generation method, okay, to spacing, so you can edit the spacing of the truss successfully. But we, for the sake of this lesson, we will go by the default settings right there. Okay, and then the profile, you can also change it as well. All right, I think everything is okay. If you want to have a cantilever, maybe a cantilever at right hand side, you can just input 1,000 right there. At left hand side as well, you can input just 1,000, just like that. Click on the okay button, so you have something of this kind. All right, so we have modeled this, so we'll be adding a member that will connect this point and this point successfully. So how do we do that? We navigate to the steel member again, and then we will be choosing beam this time around. You select beam, or you can use this frame. So if you select frame, you will have a dialog just like this, frame member dialog just like this. You just have to select these sections, and then we will be using a square sections to fill in that provisions. Alright, just like this, maybe we navigate to 800 by 5 thickness. Select that, and then click on the OK button. Then you pick this point and this point. So if you notice, it's not proper, it's not model enough. So what you need to do, come to the 3D provisions. So where you have this implant offset, you can just put 20 there. Let's see what happens there. All right, update that. So it's taking it in, so let's just make it 30. We just want it to be model enough, okay? So just like this, I think this is okay. So if you zoom closely, you will notice that it is somehow model enough. So you can now continue to place that from that point to the next point, just like this. Alright, so after having that placed, close options to close the dialog. So we have this set successfully. So what we just have to do now is we will be looking at loading the state polylines, and we'll also be looking at analyzing and as well design all the reinforced concrete members of this structure. This is a car park once again. And then I want to say that if you have any comments, drop it at the comment sections, like question, drop it at the comment sections, and don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel. Alright, so in the next lesson, we will look at how we can load this polyline and analyze design as well. So we bring the lesson to a stop here. Stay safe and stay connected. Bye for now.